Hey, if you're ready for the live Steve Austin Show podcast with myself and Vince McMahon, then give me a hell yeah.
Austin got McMahon! Austin got McMahon! You ain't gonna mold me.
Now 3 hours of live wrestling. 3 hours of live sports entertainment. You gotta help me out here. I run a podcast that's pretty loose.
Right.
Sports entertainment. 3 hours live. How tough is that to do every single week?
No one does that. And again, we're the longest running weekly episodic television show in history. When you think about how many years we've been doing this, and how many shows in 3 hours live, and here in Tulsa, I mean, it's like we're all over the world.
You know, but organically, I started to like the cat when they split him up from Swagger and Zeb Coulter, mm-hmm. went off on his own. Kind of, he was doing some impressive things in the ring and started to respect, his ability. Then they put him with Paul Heyman, who I love, but as a heel manager. So then all of a sudden you're saying, hey, now you got to hate this guy because he's guilt by association with Heyman. Then he goes back by himself. Mm-hmm. And so he kind of got thrown or lost in the shuffle and lost a little bit of direction. But before he went with Heyman, I just started liking the mm-hmm. guy because I started respecting him. And then he kind of lost his momentum. Just from a booking standpoint, what can you do to further his cause?
I'm not certain. I don't have the answer to everything.
Right.
I mean, I'm not certain. I listen to a lot of people, a lot of people's advice, and listen to the audience. I'm not so sure that I have that answer. I'm not giving up. Don't get me wrong.
Right.
And he's a great talent, in-ring talent, physically. I just, there's something missing, and, quite frankly, I don't know. I can't put my finger on it exactly to say, okay, now we're going to the day. Brock Lesnar, it's almost like when, if you recall, Jake the Snake Roberts. It's almost like when, if you recall, Jake the Snake Roberts, when he first came into the ring and he brought this big python. Oh, my God, that was like, give you the willies just watching on television. Down there, it was new. It was, and I got it, the NWO and things of that nature. To me, it was just a matter of time, if we could stay with them, before we beat them, because we had a better product. We had more passion than they did. Anytime you have talent involved and from the standpoint of controlling their own creative, you need someone to be able to sit back and help that talent develop, and be able to say yes, no. It can't be a talent saying, I'm not going to do this, or I'm not going to do. All I had, was creative skills, a really strong work ethic, a lot of luck, and a set of grapefruits.
Right.
Because when you go up against Vern Gagne, Vern Gagne was a multimillionaire. I had nothing at the time except just that. And a lot of these other guys, the guys in Kansas City, they all had money stashed away, but they didn't put it in the business. So at the same time, we're holding our own. Our competition is anything on television. Our competition is anything at a live event, whether it's Disney or a concert or whatever it is. That is tough competition.
When you're talking about Bill Watts, you've referred to him being a pretty cagey guy. One of the greatest minds in the business, in my opinion, is Jim Ross, who came mm-hmm. from the Bill Watts tree and spent his whole life in the business and is no longer with WWE. Is there heat between you guys?
There's no heat from my standpoint. I think that, there was an incident in Los Angeles, which you were a part of, and you, as a matter of fact, stated your opinion as part of that situation. I'd rather not go into it.
Yeah.
Okay. But nonetheless, I think that, it was like, oh, man, you just don't do that. It was very unprofessional and very unlike Jim. Jim and I worked very well together. I like Jim as a human being. He has a lot of institutional knowledge. And I'm not so sure we won't get back together, too.
We talk on the phone all the time, and we break down the product in the ring and what you guys are doing.
Right.
And we book the territory.
Good. Give me some ideas.
Well, I know. That's my point. Jim's one of the brightest guys I've ever heard, whether it's, a guy who's going to be a devil's advocate,
right.
bounce something off,
right.
just basic logic,
right.
common sense
right.
when it comes to the business of sports entertainment. There's been great Finnish guys, Eddie Graham down in Florida, Pat Patterson is
mm-hmm.
phenomenal.
Right.
But just all-around knowledge of the business, you really can't get anyone with more depth of knowledge than yourself or Jim Ross. I don't know that human being is walking the planet.
I don't know either. And again, it's all about growth as well. And what Jim wanted to do, and I helped him get there. His desire was to leave Connecticut, Connecticut,
right.
and go back to Oklahoma. And that's what Jim wanted to do. Well, Jim really paid his dues with me. And as you know, anyone who works with me, I never ask anyone to do anything in the ring I wouldn't do.
Right.
Or anything behind, you know, in the office I wouldn't do. And you know that is a fact.
Right.
So JR really, really worked hard. And as everyone does, and contributed greatly, JR decided his own volition, not me. I want to go back to Oklahoma, Vince. You know, I want to take it easy. You know, I want to help some, you know, but that's what I want to do. I don't want to do what I'm doing now. And it takes 24/7, 7 days a week to be able to put this product together. You can't do it on a half-assed kind of way. You can't do that. You've got to be all in on this. And when Stone Cold calls at 2 o'clock in the morning, you got to answer the phone.
Right.
So, you know, in addition to all of that, you think, consider all the vast, you know, aspects of our company now as a public company and so many places, so many different businesses that we're in and what have you. It's a big magilla, you know, and JR contributed greatly, as did you, as did so many other performers, you know, before all you guys.
Right.
And so many other executives before JR. But when someone says, burn me out, Vince, you know, I want to go over here.
Okay. I'll get his word on that. On a little bit of a talk with him. He's going to be on the podcast here very soon. I want to talk about you and me in the ring together.
Right.
We were magic. We were made for each other. You said basically that the Stone Cold character was the Vince McMahon character.
Right.
There, and I've said this before, as much as I loved working with The Rock, Bret Hart, The Undertaker, some of the best guys in the business, no one has ever reflected back at me what you did as an opponent. You know, heel, babyface, whatever, wherever I was, I got no one greater than you that did that. What in the hell was it, in your opinion, why our chemistry was what it was? Because it was, people always say, oh yeah, he got to kick the hell out of his boss. Everybody wants to beat up their boss. There's a little bit more than that.
Right.
You could put anybody in my shoes to do the thing.